1Password versus Norton Pass matchup, and it's a pretty interesting one. 1Password is a long-time industry giant, while Proton Pass is a newbie, but from a widely loved privacy company. So which one is going to keep your password safer? First off, here's a bit of background on both. 1Password started out as a Mac password manager app way back in 2005. At that time, password managers weren't really much of a thing. So they pretty much solved a problem and became quite popular. And they're still one of the most popular options, if not the most popular. And meanwhile, Proton Pass was first introduced only a couple of years ago, but their parent company, Proton AG, is a well-known name among privacy enthusiasts. The main reason for that are the Proton Mail and Proton VPN products, both of which are heavily privacy focused. So it's no surprise the Proton Pass password manager is already making headway. A big reason why both of these password managers are trusted by so many people is that they don't skimp out on privacy and security measures. Each employs the golden standard AES 256 end-to-end encryption. The entire encryption process happens locally on your device, so anything that reaches the best password manager servers is an unreadable mash of numbers and symbols. Due to this zero-knowledge architecture, nobody else but you can access your information. Now, all these claims and measures sound great on paper, but how can you be sure if they actually work? Well, in the case of Proton, their password manager, like all their products, is completely open source, meaning anyone can just go and check the source code and also point out any potential vulnerabilities. Plus, Proton Pass underwent an independent security audit. As for 1Password, it has a long list of audits and certifications by various third-party security companies. It's pretty cool that this is a regular occurrence at this point. On top of that, there's a bug bounty program where people can report vulnerabilities and receive rewards for it. So from a security standpoint, I can recommend both of these password managers. And if you want to test them yourself, I've left links to them in the description. These are also automatically going to apply the latest coupon code, so you'll be able to get the best prices. You're welcome. However, we're not just asking is Proton Pass good or is 1Password safe? We're here to find out which password manager is better. So let's see what these apps can do. To me, a password manager has to be easy and convenient to use. In the case of 1Password, no matter what device you want to get it for, it's very easy to navigate, even if you're a beginner. The interface is intuitive and adding a new item is really simple. Plus, there are a lot of different categories. You can save credit card info here, secure notes, even passport and driver's license scans. And if you get their browser extension, the autofill is seamless too. You won't need to copy-paste your logins ever again. If we do a Proton Pass review, there's a bit less flexibility of what kind of items that you can add here and fewer overall features. But despite that, the learning curve is still slightly higher. That's totally fine if you're technically inclined, but this would not be my first recommendation for a total newbie. Now, there are some tools you can expect to see in both of the password manager apps. For example, they let me separate my items into different vaults. It's a major help in finding stuff easy. Besides, I can add files for safe storage into the password manager, which is very useful for safe document keeping. You can also share items and even enter vaults. Though Proton Pass limits how many people you can share the vault with, while 1Password requires a family subscription for this feature. Then there are password generators. These can give you a strong password in a matter of seconds, and you can modify the details of it too. Another cool thing is the ability to check the security of your accounts. These tools point out old and reused passwords and can alert you about breached accounts that are related to your email. Now, no matter which password manager you pick, you can enable biometric login. It just makes logging in easier and quicker. Or you can add another login step via two-factor authentication. Usually you just use a master password to access your account, but it's a single point of entry, so if it ever gets compromised, you're cooked. And in my view, it's better to be safe than sorry. If we do a quick 1Password review, you'll find a few unique features there. For example, 1Password actually has one more additional security step, aka the security key. You get it as you're signing up for the service, and you need it whenever you want to access the vault from a new device. Thankfully, there's no need to memorize it. All the account info gets put into a downloadable PDF called your emergency kit, right as you're creating your account. Just make sure to keep it safe, eh? Another unique 1Password thing that I really like is the fact that you can add tags and custom fields to my items. And then there's travel mode. This tool can temporarily hide selected vaults while crossing borders. You just keep the vaults that you mark as safe for travel and everything gets completely removed from your device, as long as you keep travel mode on. Okay, so what about unique stuff in the Proton Pass app? As I said, this password manager is a bit more bare bones, but it still has a couple of cool tools up its sleeve. Mainly the email aliases. You can create fake emails to use for various signups, not exposing your real information this way. I also found a feature called Proton Sentinel, which uses AI to detect potential account takeover attempts and, well, prevent them. And then there's the fact that Proton Pass can seamlessly integrate with other Proton tools. Whether you want to keep all your eggs in one basket is entirely up to you, but it is a pretty neat possibility. Though in that case, the Proton subscription can become quite pricey. Speaking of subscriptions, the 2Password managers actually have pretty similar pricing. It can shift based on seasonal deals, but if you use the links in the description, I always update them with the current biggest discounts, so you'll see the best possible price. Proton Pass has a free tier for basic password storage, and it's one of the best free password manager options. Just keep in mind that it lacks some essential security features like 2FA or the Proton Sentinel protection against hackers. Meanwhile, 1Password doesn't have a free version, but it forces you into a 14-day free trial. Yeah, I said forces you to get the free trial, no matter what. I honestly respect that. They give you a chance to try out the full capability of their app and see if it fits you. Overall, both password managers are safe and they're pretty similar in price too. But in my view, 1Password does have an edge in terms of features and ease of use. That's likely why the 1Password family plan is famous, as you can set this up for your parents and even they should have no trouble navigating this password manager. Proton Pass, on the other hand, feels a bit more complicated, but it has the unique email masking feature, and it's also a nice addition if you're already using other Proton products. They all look and feel very similar. So while personally I'd go for 1Password, in the end, the decision's up to you and what you expect from a password manager. Just whatever you pick, don't forget to check the description for a discount to save some money on the subscription. That's it from me this time. Cheers. I'll see you in the next one.